And so that'll be the battle. Can the defense stop the offense? We'll see how it plays out here. Over 15,000 on hand. And we are ready for play here in Coleman Coliseum.
Well, this should be a fun one. Alabama and Auburn going at it in any activity. It's going to bring out a big crowd, going to get the blood stirring. Great environment here at Coleman Coliseum. It's a crimson out. We've given out 15,000 of those crimson t-shirts, and the crowd is ready for it.
Both teams, of course, disappointing midweek losses. Auburn to Tennessee at home, Alabama on the road. Alabama, though, has been playing some pretty good basketball. They have won 8 of their last 11 games. And we are ready as Doug Shouse throws it in the air, and Auburn will have it first in their road blue uniforms, and Jared Harper will set the stage for the Tigers.
Horace Spencer didn't make the trip for Auburn, so they're down a big man inside where they were already undermanned with Alabama, a great rebounding team.
First shot of the game by Auburn for Purefoy, and he misfires, and the first pass sails into the scorer's table. Norris says, my bad. And he's wincing in pain already. See that left elbow? Wearing a little pad. He fell hard in Fayetteville on Wednesday night. Shot it pretty well today in shoot-around. Shouldn't be a big concern for him. And there's a moving screen on Austin Wiley.
Auburn running their familiar offense, and Dazon Ingram saying, how do you do, Mr. Wiley? Slamming into him, getting the foul on Wiley. Now, Auburn, I already mentioned, they're undermanned inside. That foul trouble could be a big factor for the Tigers.
Well, good start for Alabama. Knocking home the first points of the game, and that's another offensive foul.
What Alabama does so well. Great defensive team. That has been the case down here at Alabama for years. And that tradition continues with Avery Johnson at the helm. Bama excellent at that end of the court, slowing down Auburn.
And a foul on the floor. That one will go against T.J. Dunnins. Three quick fouls against the Tigers here on the road.
A really good sign for Alabama. We talked about the scoring being a big factor as to whether they win or not. Also, getting to the foul line. They're 13-1 when they get to the foul line, at least as much as their opponent.
Last touch by Mustafa Heron. It'll belong to Alabama. Press shot clock. A takeaway. Heron affords. Riley Norris goaltending though against Jimmy Taylor.
Well, the advantage that Auburn has is their quickness. They're getting out in the passing lanes, applying pressure, forcing another turnover against Alabama. Definitely a goaltend. Jimmy Taylor trying to get that chase down shot block. But the ball definitely on its way down. Well, goaltend score basket.
They leave Ingram wide open, and he buries the three.
Don't care for the double team against Jimmy Taylor. He's not a great scorer inside. And I would take my chances against Taylor. Don't want to give up those wide open threes to Alabama.
And that'll belong to Alabama. Oh, and Bruce Pearl getting a little frustrated with his guys. Some careless passes. That's three Auburn turnovers.
The nerves early in this rivalry game, it means so much to both schools. All these players, both teams shaky with the handles here early.
Here's Taylor, guarded by Wiley. Cross court pass to Ingram. Wide open, Key.
I just don't think Jimmy Taylor is going to score enough to beat you inside, even going against single coverage. But if you let him pass it out, and the Crimson Tide getting wide open threes, as Braxton Key did on that trip, it's going to be a long night for Auburn.
Pierre-Four. He answers the bell, makes it an 8-5 game with his three-pointer. Teague. Alabama with a second. Alabama, really good offensive rebounding team.
Really good at both ends of the court. They lead the SEC in rebound margin, more than 7 per game, more than their opponents. We get double team again against Jimmy Taylor.
Ingram travels.
He's looking over at his coach, asking, did I travel? I don't feel like I did anything. The look on Avery Johnson's face says it.
Talked to Coach Johnson today about that Arkansas game. He said very disappointed the way his guys played. Felt like they weren't in it from the get-go, and surprised by that. And asked him, I said, how much do you go back and rehash that game? He says, you know what? We take spots of that game. We didn't really concentrate on the whole game, just moments. And there's a nice drive to the basket by the little guy, Jared Harper, who reminds you a little bit of an Avery Johnson type guard, doesn't he?
Built a lot like a young Avery Johnson. Small guy. Nice job slashing to the basket by Harper. A great three-point shooter, so you have to get out to him. And with his quickness, he can get to the basket. Yeah, Coach Johnson, he didn't want to talk to you, Dave.
Yeah,
he's kind of blaming you.
Yeah, that jinx to the play there.
Oh, yeah.
I'll tell you. Listen, I've been doing this 20-something years. I've jinxed a lot of teams. Yeah. Seems like every night I'm jinxing somebody,
oh,
right?
Oh, yeah. Foul shooter jinxing. You got a lot of power in your chair over here on the sideline,
yeah.
Dave.
Yeah. Right. See, both teams off to a good start offensively.
Acklemore getting that block shot. Small lineup on the court right now for Auburn with Austin Wiley out of the game right now. An opportunity for Alabama to score at the basket or hit the boards real hard.
Ingram to check. Screen from Taylor. Oleani.
So much size inside for Alabama. Tough shot by Pierre-Four, running full speed, trying to elevate and get that shot up.
That'll be the second on Ingram. Well, this is a big Alabama team. Physically a big team.
Yes.
They are a mismatch for most of this league from a size standpoint. So when you know that going in, what is your mindset as an opponent?
Well, size is so difficult to deal with, but the way you can beat it is with quickness. Like on that play, the slash back door, take advantage of Alabama. With that size, they're not going to be as quick. In Auburn, they have to use that quickness to their advantage at their offensive end of the court.
Alaniot, up and under move. There's Taylor to clean up the mess.
That's what Alabama can do. As long as they get shots, they're going to have opportunities to get those offensive boards and score.
That foul against Taylor. Timeout on the floor. SEC Network Basketball is brought to you by Autumn. Him learning the Auburn system and Coach Pearl understanding how to use him in their offense, being such a new player. He's done a whole lot of practice time.
Yeah, one practice before his first game. So a lot to learn to make his way into the Auburn system as the Tigers continue to knock down the long jumpers.
Bryce Brown gives Auburn their first lead of the game at 13-12. Here's Norris. He'll kick it. Here's Collins. Graduate transfer. Back to Norris. Shot clock down to 7. Key. Mismatch size-wise on Brown, and he couldn't get it to drop. So
Auburn's first rebound of the night right there. They're getting dominated on the backboards by Alabama.
Dante Hall just checks into the game and grabs a rebound. Collins. Morris. Pull up, jumping, no good. Hall. That's good.
I'll tell you what, as long as Alabama doesn't turn it over, they continue to get shots with the offensive rebounds until they score.
Here's Brown, guarded by Norris.
Alabama size, so difficult to overcome, but quickness can kill as well.
That three is good by Johnson. This Auburn team loves to shoot the three. The second most in the conference. They attempted 524 coming into this game.
Both these teams struggled defensively, defending the three-point line. Alabama giving up 37% from three-point range. Auburn giving up 41% from three-point range. The three is going to be a big factor, as Coach Pearl was telling us today.
That one is stolen away by Purifoy. Johnson again. Got it again.
His big guys, Dante Hall that time, reluctant to come out and defend the three-point line. Johnson lined it up and knocked it down. Auburn stroking it from downtown.
Hey, Arkansas hit 11 threes on Wednesday night, the most that Alabama's given up all year. Key wide open three. In and out. Olanian keeps it alive. Norris, he'll try it. No good. Hall slapping it around. Finally pulled out of there by Anthony McLemore. Johnson, pull up three. That one won't go.
A confident shot right there. Heat check from Johnson. Not the pace Bama wants.
Norris tap in.
And Collins pulled up a very difficult shot from the wing for Alabama, but they have such an advantage on the backboards. Any shot's a good shot when you can go rebound everything.
Here's Brown trying to get a little bit of room. Here are four. Off to Dunnins in the corner. BJ picks it to Brown. That's in and out.
Auburn not even sniffing a rebound at the defensive end of the court for Alabama.
Key. Johnson right down the middle. Avery Johnson upset with that defense. Auburn with a five-point lead. Timeout on the floor.
Ronnie Johnson has been rolling.
Come on. You watch Arkansas play Wednesday night, and they look like they might not lose another game.
Yeah. At home, they're a different animal. They get on the road at Missouri, and Missouri Tigers really hungry for a win. They're going to come up with a win. They need to play Arkansas more often. Their last SEC win was against the Razorbacks as well. 14 straight regular season losses.
Dunnins with the steal. Collins chases it. Not in time.
All the turnovers for the Crimson Tide. Setting Auburn off to a nice lead. And we talked about Alabama wanting to keep the pace of this game slow, wanting to keep the score down. Auburn on a pace to score over 100 points in this game right now.
Alabama had a season-high 18 turnovers. Wednesday, they're up to six. Avery Johnson Jr. lays one up and in.
Tough shot for runner. Avery Jr. Bama settling into a zone defense. Better find those shooters, though.
Lang can't save it. An empty possession for the Tigers.
Turnover is a problem for both these squads early. Six for Auburn, six for Bama, four for Auburn so far.
I got you.
He bumped in the lane. Lang will be whistled for his first.
Freshman Braxton Key isolated on the wing. He is leading Alabama in scoring and rebounding average. Braxton Key, outstanding freshman for the Tide.
One of only eight freshmen in the country to lead their team in scoring and rebounding. Long outlet to Corbin Collins at a High Point, North Carolina. Transferred in for one final go of it at a Morehead State graduate transfer. Good strong take to the basket for Corbin.
Corbin Collins and Avery Johnson, the last two trips, the Alabama guards getting down around the basket, able to knock down those runners. Don't have the shot blocking on the court. The inside presence not there for the Auburn Tigers. So Alabama can attack in a lot of ways.
Wiley gets it on that low block. Double team. Goes up strong on Hall, who rips it out of his hands. Lang, though, battles for it, keeps it alive, and the result is 2 points on the board for Auburn.
Nice aggressive play by Lang, getting after that basketball, getting that score.
And Harper with a hold on Johnson. That'll be the second on Harper. That'll be the 15th foul against the Tigers. Jimmy Taylor will check in for Dante Hall.
Jimmy Taylor hadn't scored a lot, but he has been very effective in this game so far for Alabama. Didn't get him the basketball all, but he's been double-teaming him, and that has led to some good scoring opportunities for the Tide.
Auburn shooting 62% from the field. Alabama, 47%. Loose ball right back to Key. There's Ingram, two-handed clutch.
Great hustle by Dazon Ingram, crashing in there to keep the ball alive for Alabama, then ending up with the bucket.
Heron. Well, that barely moved the net. It was so pure.
Mustafa Heron. Hot shooting continues for Auburn from deep.
Fifth three of the night for the Tigers. Auburn averages 8 threes per game. Second best number in the conference.
That time Auburn came a little bit later with that double team. They had Jimmy Taylor on the move trying to make a play. Auburn getting a turnover.
I don't know if that pass was intended for Lang, but it ended up in his hands.
Oh, it was a nice find.
Johnson. Batted around, two on the shot clock.
Well, nice job crashing in by Dazon Ingram. He keeps it alive and then is rewarded with the slam. Alabama has trimmed the lead down to 6. Auburn, great team. Really good tradition for Auburn and for Alabama. A lot of great players on both squads. I was looking at the jerseys from the NBA hanging in the hallways here at Coleman Coliseum.
How about 2 seconds of the shot clock? The inbounds goes to Brown. Catch, shoot, buries it.
The Tigers are hot. They're knocking down everything here early in the game. Their torrid scoring pace continues. And Alabama definitely is not going to be able to keep up with this scoring pace. They got to do a better job at the defensive end.
9-point lead is the largest of the evening. Taylor splits a double team with Jimmy Taylor with the left hand.
Well done by Taylor, slicing into the lane. Alabama, the scoring, the offense is fine. He's got to cool off these hot shooters for the Tigers at the other end.
Dumps it off to Wiley. He's fouled. How about this? With 2 seconds on the shot clock,
Got to get one up quickly. Get it in. The Bryce Brown is only a 28% three-point shooter, but able to drill that one. The low percentage doesn't affect his volume. He gets those three-point shots up. Able to drill that one, then comes back with a nice pass to set up Austin Wiley, get him to the foul line.
Wiley just 50% at the line this year, 38 out of 76. Only 5 points and 7 turnovers against Tennessee in their midweek game.
I believe it's 1 assist and 16 turnovers for Austin Wiley. Not a very strong assist to turnover ratio for the big fella.
But he did have his career high last weekend. 25 points against TCU. 21 of those in the second half. 11 of 13 from the field in that game. And a big win for Auburn in that SEC Big 12 challenge as Braxton Key hits the deck on the other end. He'll head to the free throw line. And there's a guy that needs to get it going for Alabama if they want to get back in this game. Wiley picks up his second foul. Let's see what Bruce Pearl decides to do with his young freshman with 2 fouls now.
Yeah, that is big trouble for the Auburn Tigers. Austin Wiley getting that second foul. That's the key, not making him pay. Alabama's been really good from the foul line of late. Key not close on that first attempt.
He gets that one to go. He's just 1 out of 6 from the field. Here's Johnson. Gets a nice screen by McLemore. Reverse layup.
Ronnie Johnson. All the Auburn Tigers playing with a ton of confidence at the offensive end of the court. Are setting the nets on fire at their end.
Well, not a lot of movement on the offensive end for Alabama. Shot clock now under 10.
Alabama does, they do want to slow the pace of this game down, but you don't want to slow the pace down when you have the basketball. Slow Auburn down, not let them get out into transition, get quality shot opportunities early in the shot clock.
Ronnie on to the bench. Dante Hall, Ingram, Norris, Key, and Collins on the floor for the Crimson Tide. McLemore, Johnson, Purifoy, Heron, and Brown on the floor for Auburn. Auburn has made 4 straight baskets. Can they make it 5 in a row? Yes, they can.
Another play there by Ronnie Johnson, getting to the rim, drawing that defense in, and then able to find his running mate, Bryce Brown, beyond the three-point line.
How about Brown? 3 out of 4 from behind the arc. An 11-point lead for the Tigers. Here's Key. No whistle. There's contact on McLemore. And Bruce Pearl is not happy with that. Nothing he could do. Nice move by Key.
Good Lord, did Alabama need this basket? Braxton Key drawing the contact, working his way around Brown, or through Brown, if you will, getting to the basket and a chance for a three-point play.
You know, I gotta tell you, I think that's a good no call. I think Brown kind of, there was light, limited contact. I think he just kind of.
Yeah, don't want to reward a guy for falling down.
Right.
Make him play defense. Nice concentration, though, by Key. With a guy laying at your feet, it's hard to be aggressive and attack the rim, but Key able to protect himself, yet still get that shot down and draw the foul.
Johnson will pull up for 3. No good. Listen, when Auburn misses, Alabama's getting the rebound.
Oh, yeah.
Auburn hadn't missed much.
Yeah.
Collins, pull-up jumper is good.
Beautiful move by Corbin Collins. That one dribble, pull-up mid-range shot. Alabama with five quick points. Cut that lead back to six.
Rebound story is 16-4. McLemore. He took an extra hop.
Here's Corbin Collins with the shot fake. Pulling up in the mid-range. Take that shot before the defender can get to you. Corbin Collins, textbook shot fake, pull-up jumper. Alabama getting back into the game, getting the crowd back into the game.
Key off to Collins. Norris, a catch and shoot, three.
Rhino, Riley Norris. Alabama, a quick 8-zip run.
And here comes the 15,000 on their feet. Dimes.
Dave, you said it moments ago. Alabama getting virtually every rebound. Finally, Auburn has missed a few shots in a row. Bama continuing their domination on the backboard.
Ingram working on Johnson. Paul lost it. He was trying to throw it down and lost the handle. Auburn the other way. Johnson got some contact. They're going to score.
I thought that one was still on the way up.
I did too. We'll have to take another look. They're going to say goaltending. You be the judge, Barry. I'll leave it in your hands.
This may be the toughest call that officials have to make, trying to determine whether that's goaltending or not. Auburn up by five. We'll be back.
Paul lost it. He was trying to throw it down and lost the handle. Auburn the other way. Johnson got some contact. They're going to score.
I thought that one was still on the way up.
I did too. We'll have to take another look. They're going to say goaltending. You be the judge, Barry. I'll leave it in your hands.
This may be run by Alabama. An 8-0 run.
Did you see where Dante Hall's head was?
Man.
He was like halfway up the net.
Yeah.
And his arm was, I mean, that was some move. I was more, you're more into the goaltend. I'm just in awe of his athletic ability.
Yeah. It's amazing athleticism. Talk about NBA athletes, the best in the world. These college guys are fantastic as well.
Olanian back on the floor for Alabama. That one hit referee Tim Gaddis. He was standing out of bounds, so it belonged to Alabama. You know, a couple years ago, Tim's quickness was there. He could have got out of the way.
Yeah, it happens to us all, Dave.
Yes, it does. Collins. Ingram got hammered on the way up, and he will be rewarded with a couple of freebies.
Boy, Alabama just claiming virtually every rebound in this game. As long as they're getting shots, they keep getting shots until they score.
I mean, the rebounding discrepancy now is just, it is of epic proportions at this point. 19-6.
Hard to win when the rebounding advantage is that great, but Alabama missing some foul shots, the turnovers, they are not helping themselves in a lot of ways in this ballgame.
Johnson on the floor, Ingram. To that Alabama bench with 3:18 to go before the break. Been impressed with Auburn here on the road, though. They have not backed up.
No, and they have some challenges here with their size, with their power forward, Horace Spencer, being out for this ball game. But Auburn using their quickness, using their quick break shooting ability and control this game and control the pace of this game, which is very important. Auburn up by four.
Nice pass, McLemore hangs and count it as he hit the floor.
Anthony catching that nice pass from Ronnie Johnson and taking that contact. What concentration, knowing you're going to take a hard blow when you hit that hardwood. Anthony McLemore finishing the shot and trying to finish the three-point play.
McLemore, the 6'7 freshman forward. He of the 4.0 GPA and 1670 SAT.
I thought 1600 was a limit. Wait, 1670? Oh,
yep.
Oh, great inflation. It's everywhere.
Yeah, it's not the same SAT you and I took.
That's right. I could have had a 4.0, too.
I just didn't want to.
Didn't want to show off.
Johnson, shot clock horn sounds. That won't drop. A rebound to Ronnie Johnson. That's a two, and it's in and out. And a push-off. Is that on Lanyon?
Yep, Ronnie on. Man, I tell you what, I love Ronnie Johnson's game. He controls the tempo, gets his teammates involved. What Coach Pearl was telling us this morning, when his guards are getting other people involved, not just making plays for themselves, but getting their teammates involved, this Auburn Tiger team is really hard to guard.
Armon Davis on the floor for Braxton Key. Dante Hall in for Alanian. He just picked up his second, or excuse me, that's his first. McLemore has six of the eight Auburn rebounds.
Good thing they brought Anthony. Only the second Anthony I've ever heard of. Hardaway, of course, Memphis Tiger, Orlando Magic, Penny Hardaway, also known as Anthony.
He could play a little bit.
Okay.
And a block. Good strong move by Collins. Monday on the SEC ESPN Network, SEC Inside has all your all-access pass to Ole Miss and Florida basketball with never-before-seen footage and sounds from the season. Inside the Rebels at 9 o'clock Eastern and Inside the Gators at 9:30. Both shows streaming live on the ESPN app and watch ESPN. That'll be interesting to go all-access with Andy Kennedy, won't it?
He is always entertaining, always has been. I've had all-access occasions with him, played against Coach Kennedy when he was at UAB. He always reminds me that he stuck us for 27
yes,
that night.
Yes, he does. I've heard that conversation
yes,
more than once.
And Michael White, man, he is doing quite a job down in Gainesville with those Florida Gators. Got them playing at a high level.
Florida's up seven against Kentucky. Right now, 32-25. Cats team going in the wrong direction right now.
Lost three of their last four, and fortunate to get the win over Georgia in that stretch. This is two of their last three. Avoided a three-game losing streak.
Aaron, well short.
And Auburn still can't buy a rebound. We finally have the pace of this game slowed down. Alabama's been much more effective.
The bank three. Collins apologizes, but it'll still count for three.
Gives the Michael Jordan-like shrug there as he heads back up the court. Like, hey, I'm hot.
It's a two-point game. Shot clock at five. Davis to rebound.
The way Alabama rebounds, likely to be the last trip down the court. They'll have to take a shot here with the shot clock and game clock 8 seconds different. But they're rebounding everything. Out that time by Auburn to keep the tide off the boards.
Ronnie Johnson to Smith. Battled around. 3 seconds. Davis. It'll count.
That had to be the longest 10 seconds in transition. Forcing to play half-court basketball. Alabama can guard Auburn at the three-point line. But when it gets into a scramble situation, either out of an Auburn fast break or by a guard just driving into the paint, it's advantage Auburn.
Ingram right to the rack, had it knocked out of his hands in the first possession. Nothing to show for the Crimson Tide. Auburn will have it.
After not having a turnover for so long in that first half, Alabama opens the second half with a Dazon Ingram turnover.
Pretty good shooting by both teams. 48% for Alabama, 55% for the Tigers. Two guys that love to score, Mustafa Heron, Angel Purifoy. Good guy, explosive in the first half. Heron with seven, Purifoy with three. Austin Wiley got in some foul trouble for Alabama. He played just 8 minutes. Two fouls. Norris, that one's short.
Wow.
Strange sight.
Dazon Ingram got away with a travel there. Was he corral the basketball, but he did get away with it. Alabama just dominating the backboards. A 24-10 lead in rebounding at halftime, and it continues.
Push in the back. We'll give it to Auburn. That foul against Olanion, his second. The senior transferred in from Southern Illinois. Good ball movement. Purifoy off the mark, and another rebound for the Crimson Tide. All right, he's a guy that you need to key on. 2 of 7 from the field. 7 points for Braxton. Alani on.
No double team that time for Auburn, with Alani on getting into the post, able to squeeze off a shot, but Auburn rebounded it and defended it well without double team.
Harper. That's no good. Batted around and finally into the hands of Taylor. Melania. Oh, Taylor just backed up. Dunnins moved away and Taylor fell down.
Pulling the chair, TJ Dunnins. A nice feed inside to Austin Wiley. Auburn finally gets the first 2 points of the second half.
Teams are combined to go 1 of 9 to start the second half. Alabama wants a timeout. It is a quiet, sold-out Pullman Coliseum. Auburn leads it by 4. Back in a moment.
This is going to be a fun rivalry to watch here going forward, with these two outstanding coaches building excellent programs here in the great state of Alabama.
Out of that timeout, shot clock already under 10 seconds. Braxton Key off to Norris. Back here for elbow. And short on it. Boy, Avery Johnson talked to me earlier this week about how many shots Alabama has missed from that 10-foot mark and in. It has been a problem for the Tide. Here's a little run on Ingram. Strong move, and his reverse layup won't go. It has been a struggle, and another short shot missed by the Tide.
And Alabama still pointless here in the second half. Only 2 points for both teams combined. Auburn getting those. Alabama really having a hard time. But, yeah, Coach Johnson was saying today that they're just not finishing. They're getting good scoring opportunities, just not finishing around the basket.
All right, Alabama has missed their last 8 field goal attempts. See if they can snap that streak on this possession. Here's Collins off the key. Running by Purifoy. Key. Taylor. And a foul. We'll send Taylor to the free throw line.
The good news is Alabama getting the ball down around the basket. They draw a foul. The bad news is Jimmy Taylor. Always an adventure from the foul line.
Jimmy Taylor, 53%. He is 21 out of 40 on the year, the senior. Out of Greensboro, Alabama. A little side spin.
Oh, that's painful.
You've always admired the side spin. Since the first time we saw him.
Yes. It's amazing. See that ball spinning like a globe heading toward the rim. Hard to make them that way.
Missed them both. Teams that combined to go 1-for-13 here to start the second half. Make it 1-out-of-14. Collins, pull up 3. Got it.
Nice little pass from Dazon Ingram. Pitching it back to Corbin Collins, drilling that 3-point shot. First points of the second half for the Tide.
And with all the shooting woes, Alabama only down 1. And a chance to take the lead right here. 3-on-2 run out. Collins for the lead. That'll get us to a timeout.
From way out there, Corbin Collins pulling Alabama within 1 here in the second half.
Not been very good. I mean, they are 1-8 when teams score more than 62, and they are 12-0 when they hold their opponents to less than 62.
And Alabama, after giving up over 20 points in the first 8 minutes of this game, they have really slowed Auburn down as far as scoring goes, and have fought their way back into this game. And now we'll see who can handle this pressure as it will mount as this game goes on in this rivalry game.
Ooh, Jimmy Taylor may have just picked up a foul off the ball. Nope, they're going to say it's on Norris.
Yep.
The way Taylor looked, it looked at Tim Gattis like, you've got to be kidding me. But
he was watching Riley Norris play defense and right. Thought Riley had it clean.
Off the inbounds, McLemore with the rebound, keeps it alive.
McLemore, the one Tiger who's hitting the boards hard.
Aaron had it blocked. That is a couple of rows deep on the baseline.
And Heron had a wide open 3-point shot. He decides to put it on the floor, and Braxton Key lets him know that's a bad decision, young man.
Mustafa Heron.
That's on Jimmy Taylor.
That'll be the third on Jimmy. And here comes Dante Hall when he has the opportunity to check in.
Alabama has several big men that Avery Johnson can turn to. Taylor with foul trouble. He's played really well in this ball game. Dante Hall, very effective out there as well.
By the way, one note for Alabama is that Shannon Hale, who has been out for 3 straight games due to a lower leg injury, was at practice today, and Avery Johnson did tell us that it would be a game-time decision which is good news, the fact that he is that close to playing. We haven't seen Shannon yet in the game, but the senior looks like he's getting closer to being available to play some minutes.
Yes. A nice pickup, a veteran player who has been a good scorer, a good player throughout his career in Tuscaloosa.
Dante Hall has knocked out of his hands, and it belongs to the Crimson Tide.
What an athlete Dante Hall is. Leaping up, getting his hands on the basketball to keep possession for the Tide.
Here's Ingram. Bazon with 6 points. Braxton Key working on Heron.
Impressive freshman Braxton Key is. Savvy, understanding that he did have the advantage. Not a good chance to make that shot, but he draws the foul by taking that shot.
That is the first on Mustafa Heron.
Good shot, boy.
Alabama at the free throw line. They are now 5 of 11. 45% clip. 0 for 3 here in the second half.
After 6 minutes of play in the second half, it was 4 to 4. Before that shot,
Birafoy knocks home that three, and that look pretty much says it all for Avery Johnson.
Hard to defend that. Vangel Birafoy just rising up over the defense in transition, drilling that three.
Oh, poked away by Heron. Here's Johnson. Well, I like watching Bryce Brown. He comes down the court. Once he crosses the half-court line, Bryce Brown's hands are ready to shoot.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, he is in the shooting position at all times.
Yeah. You don't worry about throwing the ball to him, whether he's going to catch it or not. He is cocked and ready. Also love seeing Ronnie Johnson back in the game. Just a good ball handler, floor general for the Tigers.
Crossover, pull up. Too strong by Johnson. Avery Johnson. Ingram around to Collins. And a hand check on Heron. That'll be the second on Mustafa. See what's coming up on Tuesday. LSU will travel to Kentucky. That game went on ESPN. Alabama and South Carolina right here on the SEC network.
Ingram has such a good 3-point shooting opportunity there. So early in the shot clock.
Ooh. Not a good pass by Ingram. Kept it alive though. Johnson from the corner. Got it.
Not his game, Avery Johnson, not a great three-point shooter, only 32% on the season, but wide open, able to knock that down. Good hustle by Dazon Ingram to keep possession for Alabama.
Two-point game. 3-4. He rips the net from the corner right in front of his bench.
Ronnie Johnson again, the dribble penetration, and then the great find, cross-court, wide open jumper, Purifoy, pure.
Those points he scored since he has returned from that ankle injury.
Watch out.
He rattles through the rim.
Oh, Braxton Key, he's got that old man game. He's taking his time, getting a handle on the basketball, and drilling that jumper.
Alabama hanging around. Three-point contest. 11:45 to go. Johnson, full up three. He buries it. His third three of the night.
Johnny Johnson, he is a killer. Coming off that bench and giving Auburn a spark since he's come into the game.
Foul on Brown, but the three-point shot has been big for the Auburn Tigers. 10 of them.
Dangell Purifoy pulling up in transition. Auburn still in control, up six. Into that NCAA tournament conversation, have a solid RPI. Ball's able to go on the road and win at Auburn this week, but couldn't get the sweep of the week and get a win down in Starkville as well.
Avery Johnson will pick it up in the backcourt. Guarded by Ronnie Johnson. Collins. A tough shot. But Alabama does what they do, and they get another offensive rebound.
For most of the evening, any shot's been a good shot. Bama can go get the rebound.
Key drives, gets fouled, and he'll head to the free throw line.
Savvy move by Braxton Key. Good job drawing the foul. Only a 63% foul shooter. Got to improve in that category.
He's the reigning SEC first of the week. Don't forget, coming up at the conclusion of this one, stick around for SEC Now, our network analyst breakdown and analyze a full day of college hoops action right here in the SEC. It's also streaming live on the ESPN app and watch ESPN. Point game. Auburn's led by as many as 11. Making an 8-point game is Brown. Gets a little low five from his coach on the way back down the floor. The last four field goals by Auburn have all been behind the arc. Well, Collins got to watch that lead arm.
Giving him the Heisman.
Here's Johnson. He's trying to find a little bit of room. That won't go, but it belongs to Auburn.
All night long, Auburn drilling three-point shots. Bryce Brown here giving coach a little dap and giving his club an 8-point lead.
Well, what did he say? We got to shoot the three well.
Hey,
they've done a pretty good job of it.
They're getting it done. They're using their quickness. Despite the rebound disparity in Alabama's favor, Auburn, with their great three-point shooting, holding that lead.
You know, they've done a better job, Auburn has. They've closed the gap to 10. They're minus 10 in the rebound department.
You live with that.
Jimmy Taylor picks up his fourth. I just feel like Alabama's got a run in them. We haven't seen it, really.
Yeah.
I feel like they've got one of those 8-10-point runs still in them.
They had one. They were down 11 in the first half and a nice little 8-point burst. But as long as Auburn continues to rein in the three-point shots, T.J. Lang on that one, it is coming from a variety of sources. The Tigers extend that lead to 11.
The 12th three of the night. That is the most Alabama has given up all year. Ingram. His little floater in the lane is good.
Drive by Dazon Ingram. When we're about to cross the 62-point line, Alabama has not won a game when giving up more than 62 points this season.
Boy, Wiley just crashes into the lane and picks up the foul. And for the freshman, that'll be his fourth. It has not been a night where Austin's developed much of a sweat. He's played about 13 minutes tonight because of foul trouble.
Picked up a cheap one early, and that foul trouble has continued all night long.
Alabama
trimmed it to nine, and good drive by Ingram. Couldn't quite get the three-point play opportunity, but Alabama attacking the rim and parading to the foul line.
And what did we hear from Coach Johnson on our SEC Wired segment? It was
drive it.
Drive the basketball. P.J. Dunnins has picked up his second foul. But you got to make your free throws.
Yes.
Ingram. 65% at the line. He's now been there closing in on 115 times.
One time.
Shooting a very good percentage at the line, but Alabama, that advantage, rebounding.
Taylor trying to set a screen, offensive foul.
Quick feet from Jared Harper, getting over in front of Ingram. Sometimes it's an advantage to be small. Not a lot of contact, but when you're a little guy like Harper is, you go flying and gets the call.
And Harper is fouled by Ingram and makes the three, a four-point opportunity coming up. That is not a good sequence for the Crimson Tide.
Not a good sequence for Dazon Ingram. He fouls Harper on two plays in a row at the offensive end and then on the three-point shot. Jared Harper drilling that three-point shot. Definitely contact. Harper goes to the deck, and he will go to the line to try to complete the four-point play and give Alabama, or give Auburn, 11, I believe, is their biggest lead. Trying to get it to 12 right now.
And Harper converts. So 7 for Jared Harper. Now he has the task of trying to stop Key. Key takes him in the paint, who gets that one rejected by McLemore. Back out to Johnson. How about that rebound?
Well, you're having a great rebounding night when even sitting on your backside, you can get a rebound.
And the foul by Taylor.
Alabama got the lead down to 10. We get under 8 minutes. We talked about the pace, and Alabama wants to play it slow. I think at this point, in order to have enough possessions to get back in this game, Alabama is going to need for the tempo to pick up.
Dunnins off the backboard. Back out to 12. Top of the key from Key. Long rebound. Alabama behind the arc, 6 out of 22. That'll get us to our under 8 media timeout as Auburn has pushed this one back out to 12.
Jared Harper knocking down that three-point shot. The rain from three land continues for Auburn. Bama on the boards, but they're getting
an SEC record. They knocked home 21 three-pointers against Coastal Carolina. There were 21 of 42. They led the SEC last year, averaging 8.8 three-pointers made per game. This year, they're 8.1. And obviously, we're triple upwards. So Jimmy Taylor misses the free throw.
Front end of the 1-1 there for Jimmy Taylor. Predictable coming out of a timeout. A guy who's not comfortable shooting foul shots, having to think about it that whole time.
I mean, this is now getting crazy. That is number 14.
The Auburn Tigers explosive and feeling comfortable and confident behind that three-point line tonight.
this is staggering. They started 0 for 5 this half behind the arc, did Auburn. They're now 7 of 7 since that start. There's Collins. Nice with the shot. Collins has really been their offense for the most part here in the second half.
Yeah, hadn't been much offense. Alabama had 39 points at the half, only 17 here in the second half. So far, barely boiling a point per minute pace in the second half for the Crimson Tide.
Ingram.
Rezon Ingram providing a spark. Trying to pull his club back. Auburn just moments ago had their largest lead at 15. Alabama has quickly trimmed it to 11.
Ingram up to 11.
Very difficult shot over the shot blocker, Jimmy Taylor. Able to knock home that runner. Get Auburn back up by 13.
Norris over the key. They're going to say it's Auburn basketball.
Here's Dangelo Purifoy. The ball swinging to him. Trying to draw the foul, going to the deck. But Auburn smoking hot from the field, knocking home threes, getting to the basket. The Auburn Tigers clicking tonight. 13-point lead, trying to get the sweep over the Crimson Tide.
You know, Purifoy's been among Auburn's leading scorers. But he has really been struggling. He may be busting out of that here tonight.
Nothing like a game like this. You get your stroke back. Confidence comes back. And you're Purifoy getting back to playing the way that he can.
Purifoy has 10 double-figure scoring games. And he will get fouled, right?
Yep.
Underneath the basket and head to the free throw line.
Alabama casual with the basketball. Braxton Key not recognizing that Purifoy is there. And he's standing on that restricted area line. So it's a block. And Auburn continuing to maintain control.
And these are the same issues that Alabama faced on Wednesday.
Make the right play right now. Score, get stops. There's still time to catch up.
Purifoy. Dan Gill, 13 points in 23 minutes. Able to knock that one home. Redshirted last season. A four-star prospect. 25 points, 11 rebounds at Hargrave Military Academy. And Ingram with a nice strong move.
Well, that possession was not going very well for the Crimson Tide. A lot of standing around waiting for screens to come. Dazon Ingram just gets it, drives it. Fortunate to get that roll. A chance for a three-point play to try and chip away at this big Auburn lead as the clock has ticked under 5 minutes to play.
That's what we just heard Coach Johnson say. It's easier for his team to get the three at the basket as opposed to from behind the arc.
Every once in a while, a coach will know what he's talking about.
See if Ingram can convert this turnover. Norris misfires. Here for the rebound.
And great opportunity there for Riley Norris. An open three-point shot. His team desperate to claw their way back into the game. Now Auburn really working on that clock.
Collins, the rebound. Closing in on 4 minutes to go. Collins, step back three. Got it.
Nice drive by Braxton Key, kicking it out to Corbin Collins. Lead down to 9 now.
Timeout taken by Auburn. Collins having a heck of a game now with 17. You see Collins with 17. Has three threes in this game as well. Overall, Alabama shooting 43%. Auburn at 50%. Right on the button, they've hit 26 out of 52. But 14 of those 26 field goals made have been three-pointers, which is an SEC high for the Tigers.
42 of their 73 points coming from three-point range. Outsized by the Crimson Tide, but Auburn which is raining home three-point shots all night.
And Harper just hit that one over Dante Hall.
That is nearly impossible shot. Moving left, dribbling into that shot with a 6'10 guy coming at him. Jared Harper.
Watch this three by Harper a minute ago.
When you're hot. Good Lord. Auburn just scorching the night from three-point range. Now 15 threes on the night. Point lead, milk the clock.
Ooh, big collision. Key steps right into Harper. That's his fourth. I mean, that is just crazy numbers by Auburn on the road in particular.
Yeah. 15 out of 27, they have made themselves right at home here at Coleman Coliseum tonight.
Been a pretty good team on the road. They're 4-2 on the road. They have not been intimidated at all this year, despite being such a young team.
They're able to hold on here. Looks like they will. Their fifth road win of the season to match Georgia and South Carolina for tops in the SEC as far as winning true road games.
Collins picks up his first. You know, coming into the day, SEC road teams were 32-32.
Long term, it's about a 35% proposition to win on the road in the SEC. So to get to 50 this year, amazing by the road teams.
Foul by Davis. Why do you think that is? This is such, it's the youngest overall league in the country in terms of experience. So why do you think the road teams have had so much success? You'd think it'd be the other way around.
Dave, as a as an expert analyst, 24 years experience in the business, I'm going to tell you, I have absolutely road teams are winning so much this year in the SEC.
You would think it would have to be senior-laden experience clubs.
Yeah. Makes no sense whatsoever.
Harper's had a nice second half. He's now up to 13 points. If nothing else, Auburn is a fun team to watch.
Oh, man, they are. And no surprise with the guy roaming the sidelines for the Auburn Tigers. Tell you what, man, he is kind of like my head coach at Vanderbilt. Sam Newton, who's beloved here in Alabama, head coach for 11 years down in Tuscaloosa, beloved in Nashville, head coach at Vanderbilt for 8 years, and beloved at Kentucky, a player there, athletic director for a long time at UK, and Bruce Pearl, and people in Nashville still telling me, hey, when you see Coach Pearl, tell him go Vols. And, you know, there's love back for Tennessee as well from Coach Pearl. Remarkable.
Always great also to see Sonny Smith and Whip Sanderson together at the game. Those two guys, of course, battled it out for so long, but such good friends now. And talk about some stories. But hey, more stories and SEC hoops coming your way Tuesday right here on the SEC ESPN Network. College hoops doubleheader starting at 6:30. This Alabama team taking on 19th-ranked South Carolina. That'll be followed at 8:30, Vanderbilt and Arkansas. Join us for that. Double dip on Tuesday night. You look at the SEC standings. Kentucky with their hands full with Florida right now. South Carolina by the end of the night might be in sole possession of first place. Braxton Key never really got untracked tonight. Key. We'll head to the free throw line, but Braxton Key, 3 of 11 from the floor. Does have 7 rebounds and 4 assists. A balanced game in that regard, but still really found a shot.
Yeah. He's been to the foul line quite a bit, but really never got rolling from the field. As
Alabama's leading scorer,
leading rebounder. Still productive, puts up nice numbers tonight.
And what I like about it, too, though, is that, you know, while his shot wasn't going down, he still got to the free throw line, got some points, you know. Some guys disappear.
Yeah, that's what a scorer does. You find a way to get some points on the board for your team. Braxton Key, a scorer for sure.
Riley Norris with a dunk. We got ourselves an 8-point game with 1:38 to go. We've seen crazier things happen.
Force a turnover, and if you don't get it, you have to foul as soon as Auburn gets the ball across half court. With only a minute 38 left to play, you got to try and extend this game, create as many possessions as possible.
All right, they got another turnover. Key with a throw-in. It's a 6-point game. Buckle up.
So close to another steal by Dazon Ingram. Got a foul right now.
Two-possession game.
Coach Johnson choosing not to foul. Going to play this possession out.
And Auburn will take a timeout. And Auburn has burned their last timeout. Mustafa Heron will inbound it for the Tigers. This was a 15-point game here in the second half. And at no point did you feel like Alabama had any control of it. Johnson, 7 seconds. He lost the basketball, and it's Alabama's possession. That's 4 straight turnovers by the Tigers.
And for Auburn, they just got to remind themselves, hey, we're still ahead, still up by 6. Just calm down. Ronnie Johnson goes to the deck, his hand out of bounds as he skids to the floor. Great opportunity for Alabama, and they continue to get to the rack.
Dazon Ingram. Throws it down.
At a minute, they do let one more second go off the clock. Auburn having all kinds of trouble with this pressure.
Crowd with an offensive foul. Heron has it now. They're going to call a block on Norris.
Against this Alabama pressure, Auburn just trying to maintain control of the basketball, and Heron decides, hey, I'm going to take it to the rack. They're scrambling to put the pressure on. I'm just going to drive it. gets the block. Now to hit these foul shots.
A lot of folks here thought there was a foul all the way back at the other end of the floor. So Heron at the free throw line. And here's what the crowd got really upset about on this turn right here.
Not a lot of contact there. I like the no call. Thought it was closer to a foul when he extended his elbow on the dribble. Jared Harper able to hang on to the basketball. Now Auburn's up six.
Ingram backing up Harper. Collins. Ball fake. Three on the way. McLemore. Fouled a couple of times and Chuck Jones will get in there along with Doug Shouse.
Rivalry game. Gotta look out for tempers flaring, but big rebound by Anthony McLemore. Going up, snatching that board and settling things down for Auburn. Getting that possession. Now the tied up six, about to step to the foul line. Back in control of this game.
And it looks like Doug and Doug Shouse and Chuck Jones are going to take a look at the replay to see if there was perhaps an elbow somewhere in that mix. There were so many guys, it's hard for me to see.
McLemore had his elbows high. And definitely some swatting at McLemore, swatting at his arms, but I don't see anything out of bounds there by Anthony McLemore, so we play on. McLemore steps to the line. Didn't have those elbows up though, boys. Protecting that basketball.
So McLemore off the back of the iron. 66% of the line this year. The freshman out of Warwick, Georgia. Missed them both.
As Johnson said, drive it, get to the rim. Better chance for three at the rim.
Or Davis from the corner. 3-point game.
One possession game.
Almost picked off by Ingram. Here's Harper.
Got a foul.
Heron.
Shot clock's off.
Norris with a quick foul.
What a big shot by Armand Davis. Reining in that three-point shot to trim the lead to three. Remarkably, Alabama giving themselves a chance to tie this ballgame. Big foul shot for Heron.
Heron on the year, 76%. He has been perfect tonight. And he continues. Mustafa Heron. At 15 points in that first meeting with the Crimson Tide.
Freshman looks like a senior. Reminds me of Marquise Daniels. Kind of built like Daniels. Great Auburn Tiger from the early 00s.
Alabama uses
with just 16 seconds left.
Heron with double figures in every game he has put on the Auburn jersey. Now 23 straight. That's 13 points this evening. Ingram. Davis. Fall away three. No good, and that one is knocked out of bounds. We're going to give it to Alabama with 7.7 seconds.
As long as Auburn doesn't turn it over, it's going to be hard to lose this game. In Alabama, at this stage, you definitely got to try for a three-point shot.
Riley Norris. No good. Tapped around. 2 seconds. One final chance for Alabama, but this one at 82-77. No timeouts for either team.
tell you what, an impressive win by the Auburn Tigers, getting a sweep against the Crimson Tide, making these Tigers feel good.
And the game will end on that. Valiant effort by Alabama. They were down 15.